David.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
And welcome to Sunday night.
Our vortex of music and...
Whoa!
Yes. It is, isn't it?
It's good, Jules. It's nice. You worked with him earlier, right?
Well, it's nice for us all to be here. And to be nice. Oh! It's a lovely show we've got as well this evening.
I think it's a great show. Let me ask you a question. Who was the first person you ever played with?
The first person that I ever played with, this is quite true, was Glenn Tilbrook from Squeeze when I was about 14. And we played in a pub. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to spit there.
No,
we played in a pub. And in this pub in which we played, we were paid £15. The equivalent, I suppose, of $30 these days. Mm-hmm. Not a lot. But it made me realise, but it was much more than my friends were getting at school. It made me realise that it was good to be a musician because you didn't have to get up in the morning and apparently got loads of money.
One of the perks, right?
Yes.
You don't have to get up early.
Yes, and that was it. And from that moment on, after just playing with him once in this pub, we had to pretend we were older than we were to get in, obviously, my whole life turned around, you know.
It made you who you are today.
It made me the living... vortex
thing.
Of music and love that I am today. How about yourself? Who was the first person?
First person I ever worked with was Albert King, but the first person I played with was little Milton Campbell, who, interestingly enough...
is here this evening, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, he is.
And I'm really looking forward to getting a chance to play with him again.
And did he give you much encouragement?
Yes, he did. He gave me a lot of encouragement. He was a real inspiration to me. He's a tremendous player.
That's good, isn't it? It's all round, I think. It's nice when things are round and circular and it all sort of comes together. I like that. Also, of course, we have on the show, who do we have? We have the Gotham Groove Masters, the Lounge Lizards, ladies and gentlemen.
And a trio of singing sisters, the Roches.
Each week, of course, I have, yes, indeed, whistle away. Why don't you? Because it's almost like it's a catchphrase, isn't it? I've had my one. I can't apologise enough, but I think it's time that you had one of your own.
Yes, I think so. Well, a catch gesture, I think, would be more appropriate. Maybe,
I like that very much.
Okay.
Let's hear a yes. Let's try that again. Yes. Okay. Maybe that's good. Understated, perfect. And perhaps you
could do the first part of the catch gesture.
Oh, it's in two parts?
Yeah, that's right.
The second part is walking over with the band. Yes. And walking over with the band. Because David has done his gesture, he's now walking over to be reunited with the man in France they call Petit Milton, the legendary blues singer, guitarist, Little Milton, ladies and gentlemen.
she left me. I'm glad she gave me the blues. You see, I'm grateful to the blues. It was the blues that brought me to you. Yeah, she said she'd never given me the blues. I never would have found someone sweet like you. That's why he said again.
Little bit of making whoopee there, you see, and I think in many ways that completely epitomises this show. Everything, you see, and the marvellous thing about this show is the word pigeonhole never raises its ugly head. Jazz, rock and roll, reggae, gospel are all accommodated. So now I'm pleased to introduce something in the folk idiom. Please welcome three sisters, three highly acclaimed sisters from New York, the Roches, ladies and gentlemen.
Lucky. Stop. Is a machine designed to keep you on time. And this is what makes it tick. People working together with
my favorite. That's my favorite part of the show.
My, it is. We do have. I think even without blowing my own or our own trumpet or playing my own piano, we do have good archive footage on this film.
I think it's great. Show. Yeah, and that one particularly was great. Count Basie and Coleman Hawkins on tenor saxophone.
They're all there.
Vic Dickinson on trombone. Jerry Mulligan on baritone. And Joe Newman on trumpet.
Yeah, Count Basie, of course, on piano.
Right, right. Doing that. Great, some great stride piano.
But no, he was playing the piano. Thank you, Marcus. That's it. And he did, of course, have his own personalised piano, and I think that's, which was, of course, Alan Thingy. People have been viewing the show for a while.
Is that true?
This piano's father. People who have been viewing the show for a while will know that this is Nigel Thingy. This is my own personal piano. And a while ago, I did invite the viewers to write
right.
in.
And this is the fruit of that...
The fruit of that loin, because here is a bearing in mind, I think it's marvellous that it is a completely inanimate object that they've that people have written into. Should I read you a brief excerpt?
Is this one of the ones from your mother?
No, there were two from my mother. That's
there
quite
was
true.
Four from your mother, Jules. Come
yes.
on.
Well, yes, there we are then. That, it says, thanks for the great show so far and for spelling night, N-I-T-E. I've always felt that the G-H has no place in the word. This is sort of people. Well, no, that's fair enough. He then goes on to ask for Frank Zappa on the show, and he says if we could write to him to let him know. Well, and he also says it's wonderful because where else but America can a person such as myself write a letter to a piano? Indeed.
I have no answer to that, Jules.
I think what we're saying is people write in to Nigel if you want, you know.
That's right. Continue.
But don't expect a reply.
That's right.
I think is the answer. Oh, well, anything else you want to chattle about?
No.
I feel as
That's
I've
it.
Just
I, your
on.
Eyeballs
I'm
are spinning
sorry.
Again, Jules.
I know. It's yeah, I've been round the back of the building exercising and it's worn me out. I think it's time to move on.
I think so.
What should we have?
Why don't we have the Roches?
I think we should. Ladies and gentlemen, the Roches.
When you see me coming, too much trouble. When
Michelob.
Something big is happening. All the brightest stars are on sale right now at The Warehouse. Get big savings on CDs, cassettes, movies, and hundreds of other items store-wide. Register to win a superstar European trip, so go for the stars. Get Billboard's top rock and roll hits, CDs $8.99 and cassettes $4.99. Plus Roy Orbison's Mystery Girl, CDs $11.99, cassettes $6.99. Hurry in for music, movies, and more. Where? At The Warehouse.
Hi, friends. Ralph Williams of Wilson Ford. I'd like to make this the biggest record volume sales weekend we've ever had in 22 years at Wilson Ford, and we can do it. You come see us if you're going to buy a new Ford car or truck, and I don't care where you live. It's going to make it worth your while. All 89 Mustangs, 99 over Ford factory invoice. Let the convertibles go at the price. I don't care. 89 Aerostars, $10,988. Had credit problems? Don't give up. Call now and ask for one of our credit counselors. I believe we can help you. But don't buy until you've come to Wilson Ford, Beach Boulevard, Huntington Beach.
Well, joining us now is not only one of my favorite musicians, but one who, as I said before, helped give me my start in the music business, little Milton Campbell.
All right.
Little Milton.
All
right. Pleasure to have you.
My pleasure.
Now, you got your start with another famous or notorious musician, Ike Turner.
We won't say notorious.
No. We won't tell a story about how he locked people in the studio.
I don't even know about that, anyway. But yeah, he was very much instrumental in getting me into the studio for the very first time. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Now, you and Ike were both part of the St. Louis scene. That included Fontella Bass and Albert King. Fontella Bass was on the ship, by the way.
Yeah, and she was great. I saw that.
Yeah, she is great. And Oliver Sane. And right. what was the scene like in St. Louis?
I was having a lot of fun. I'm sure you can remember back.
Yeah.
How many years ago? Tell the age thing, you know. Yeah. But it was a lot of fun. And with the Bobbin Record Company just being born, as you might say.
And you were a co-owner of that.
Well, I was supposed to be.
But you didn't share in the fruits of it. Well, in name, right?
Not in name only.
Responsibility and none of the benefits.
Yeah, right, you know.
Well,
but anyway.
You had a lot of records on. You have a record on the charts recently. I understand that you were also inducted into the. What is it?
WC Handy
Hall of Fame. Right. Now, what is that? What is that exactly?
Well, to me, it's a great honor, you know, because it comes to, like the Memphis scene thing, you know, yeah. Everything comes from the Bill Street and all that, so forth and so. And it's going pretty big now, and it's very prestigious, and I'm happy to have been one of the guys.
Well, I can't think of anybody more deserving.
Thank you, Dave.
Now, do you want to tell us about this next song that we're going to do?
Yeah, this is from my current LP. With the Malico Record people, mm-hmm. And the name of the tune is I Don't Believe in Ghosts.
All right, let's do it.
All right.
Things are falling, voices calling, somebody's trying to steal your love from me. Hey! You took too long to open up the door, and you claimed that it was jammed. But when I finally got inside, I heard my back door slam. The cologne that I wear is like a fill, but the air was filled with Pierre Cardin. Hey! Don't believe in ghosts, people. I believe another man is in my house. There's something strange going on around here, and I'm damn sure gonna find out. Listen, I worked real hard for what I got. Here's where I intend to stay. Before I let another man take over.
looking to my window to see. But oh, would you believe this, people? My own damn dog bit me. Don't believe in gold, people, but I believe another man is in my house. There's something strange going on around here, and I'm damn sure gonna find out. Here's another thing. Now the telephone, it keeps acting up. Whenever she answers it, it's always fine. But no matter how I try to pick it up, it goes click every damn time. Don't believe in ghosts, no. I believe another man is in my house. Something strange going on right here, and I'm damn sure gonna find out. Hey, baby, what took you so long to open the door? No, don't give me that. You can't be that sleepy. And whose shoes are those over there? Mm-mm, I didn't leave mine over there. I think I better check this closet. Look at the bed moving in. Somebody must be under it. Hey, is anybody under this bed? You better talk to me, woman. You got some explaining to do. I don't believe in ghosts. Talk about me now. Mm-mm. Ain't no such thing as ghosts. I don't believe in ghosts. No ghosts. No ghosts.
Hi, friends. Ralph Williams for Wilson Ford. We're going to be here till midnight tonight. And if you're going to buy a new Ford car or truck, I'd like to recommend that you, regardless of where you live, you get in your car or truck and drive on down to Wilson Ford. I think you'll drive home in a new Ford car or truck. Believe me, I believe you're going to save a lot of money. All 89 Bronco 2s, 99 over Ford factory invoice, and all Mustangs, regardless of the model, including the convertibles, 99 over Ford factory invoice. Had credit problems, call and ask for one of our credit counselors now. Open tonight till midnight. We're located Beach Boulevard, Huntington Beach.
A beginning skier usually has trouble feeling confident, but when the California Handicapped Skiers Foundation is doing the teaching, confidence is one of the first lessons. The students are disabled children from all over Los Angeles. The foundation school in San Bernardino County teaches skiing basics using volunteer instructors and facilities at Bear Mountain.
Once a child who is disabled...
So, welcome back, and John Lurie of the Lounge Lizards is... with me now. I think I could say that, couldn't I? I think we are with one another now, aren't we?
That's safe, yes.
I think that's a safe beginning. And I did have we did have an introduction written out for you.
Let me see it.
Well, I have it here, but you expressed some concern, understandably, with it, but, and I think words are such blunt instruments, so I'd rather get it exactly. I don't want anybody to be unhappy with what we might say. John Lurie, is that a good start?
That's my name, yeah.
And that's a good beginning, then?
Yeah.
Of our next act?
I don't know, yeah, I think so.
Oh, well, that's good. It's all right so far, then. Has described their music as fission more than fusion.
Well, you know, it's just people ask you to describe your music and you try to avoid that. So they say, is your music fusion? And then you just say something. Really, you know, that I have all these feelings inside of me and I like to, express those feelings through music and make other people feel the same way.
Well, that's a wonderful thing. I'm glad that you've... That's good. Good, I'm pleased. Here, I mean, it's a perfect place because we're being filmed and captured forever.
No. What's next?
I think you're groovy rather than gravy. You didn't want to... Oh, dear.
I'm sorry.
I didn't want to upset you. I mean, your music makes me feel... The next number, especially, is gets me all frenzied up, actually. I hope that, that when you're doing the next number, the cameras don't cut away to me, because I will be in frenzy state. Really, it does. I like it very much. It does. It's not, you know... There you are, then. Anything you'd like to add, do you think?
No, I'm all right. Thank you, Jules.
No, thank you very much, John. John, thank you for being you and being here. Thank you. So, what's the next, what is it called?
Oh, The Voice of Chunk.
Thank you.
Tower Records is having a soundtrack sale from Warner, Elektra, Atlantic, and Geffen.
For $10,000, this CD is a prudent investment with substantial revenue potential. Unfortunately, it's boring. Which CD should you buy?
Well, it's a marvelous night for a moon dance.
Still time to change the road.
Enter now at Tower to win one of three revolutionary Pioneer multi-play CD systems. The soundtrack sale. Now at Tower.
Hi, friends. Ralph Williams for Wilson Ford. I'd like to have this be the largest volume sales weekend we've ever had in the 22-year history of Wilson Ford. I know of one way to do it. Slash prices. Every 89 Bronco 2 this weekend, 99 over Ford factory invoice. Every 89 Mustang, regardless of the model, 99 over Ford factory invoice. You don't live too far away to save money. Remember, open tonight till midnight. Had credit problems, call now and ask for one of our credit counselors. But come see us before you buy any new Ford car or truck. Wilson Ford, Beach Boulevard, Huntington Beach.
I'm here with my friends.
For the best bargains in town.
And for the wonderful fun. Look at the giveaway price on these dishes.
Or these toddlers' outfits.
Oh, I love the shampoo.
Candy!
Nice.
Socks for the kids.
Pick and Save prices are so low, things go fast.
And once they're gone, they're gone.
So if you don't come to Pick and Save this week...
Think of the fun and the bargains you'll miss, like castanets.
Oh, good.
Oh.
Well, yeah, another frenzied night of music and love has come to an end, Jules.
Yes, alas.
Alas, yeah. Well, I'd like to thank our guests, starting off with Little Milton Campbell. Little Milton. Thank you. Thank you.
And the Roches, ladies and gentlemen.
And the Lounge Lizards.
Also, Marcus Miller, because he was here again, wasn't he?
That's right.
I like seeing him.
Twice in a row.
And not forgetting, of course, our famous Sunday night band. Who you can't see because we're all standing in front of them.
That's right.
Yes.
And, well, as a closer, why don't we do, even though we all feel so good, why don't we do Milton's song, Feel... So Bad.
All right, let's do it.
Good idea. I'll repair to the piano. This way, please, ladies.
Shake my head and walk away. Walk away. I'm trying to tell you people. I want to tell you all the way I feel. I'm trying to tell everybody. I want to tell you the way I feel. Feel so bad. Yes, I do. My baby gave me a dirty.